Hello Gundam fans, this is Brom92, and today I'll be looking at the 144 High Grade Earthree Gundam from Gundam Build Divers Revise, and I got the model kit from Canadian Gundam. Link is in the description below. So I've already gone into in-depth detail on the core Gundam itself in a separate video, which I'll link to. And it's taken me a little while to do this video on the actual Earthree, because if you watch the core Gundam video at the end with the comparisons, the core Gundam was missing the red jewel. Between the recording and then doing the side-by-side comparison shots, the core Gundam fell off the shelf, and the V-fin came off, and the jewel just disappeared. So I ordered another kit, and that's actually fixes two things, because the one, I can't remember the name of it, but it's the underwater version, is just the armor, not the core Gundam. So I have another one, and if I find the jewel, I'll put it on the new one that I haven't built yet. So it does serve a purpose, but that's really annoying. So anyways, we're going to focus on the actual Earth armor for now, because I really do like how it looks. The whole thing goes together very solidly. It looks pretty good, I think. The only sticker is for the cockpit in metallic green. And I like the fact that it comes with a little stand to display it on. I think it looks good by itself, and when I am going to build the armor in the second kit and display it like this, because I do like it. Got the gun under there, the shield on the back for like a tail fin, little baby wings. I do like it. Now, of course, you do have to rip everything off in order to get it ready for the combination, which can be a little difficult. It's mostly the chest pieces that are the problem, because the top part is separate, and also taking these side skirts off the tabs has stressed it. You can see it there and a little bit there, but mostly on that side. You can kind of see it far beyond the other side. Not good. So be careful with that. Stress mark seems to be a common theme of the this kit for some reason. It's because of the whole combination and everything. I understand. But I'm not planning to do it a whole bunch. The V-fin can be a little tricky to get off. And thankfully, if that goes flying, I have an extra one. And putting the side pieces on initially is a little bit of a hassle, but once you do it a couple of times, you figure out exactly how to slide it in. And then just get the gun out. And that's what you have left. Just a bare little flyer. I like the parts from like the double Zeta, the Zeta high grades. I have the core piece where I put all the parts on. Now there's a little bit of transformation you have to do with the core gun to get it ready. First off, you have to remove its hands, fold the ankles back to reveal the little ports it's going to use. And then flip up the beam saber handles into the standard Gundam orientation. And then also extend the torso. I love that little sliding track. Just very simple, but it does bulk it out just enough. So now that we have everything separated, I'm going to start with the torso just because it makes it easier. You don't have to like bump into other stuff and knock the other armor off. And it also can be a little tricky to get it in here without sliding the new joint into the body. And then you just paint the top piece on, and it's good to go. It works rather well. And that's all done. Now, the front skirts are a lot easier than I thought they'd be. Much like the Age Gundam, just has them from the back. And it holds rather well. Now, doing this a lot might make it really loose. I don't know. But it's possible. And the legs are pretty easy. Just want to make sure it's the ports are straight. The round parts for the ankles are now going to be the knees, which is pretty cool. And this just looks like it could be like for a vent for a thruster with the foot. So, yeah. It looks pretty good. I definitely like how they did the whole leg setup. Works very well. And the shoulders just simply slide into the grooves on the white armor. And then the lower arms peg into where the hands were. And then you can just put the hands into there. And then I love the fact that they give you little hand covers with the appropriate color. Because I could have easily left that, like, this just normal dark gray, navy bluish color. But I like that they didn't. And then we can put the back skirt onto the big port in his bum. And the backpack on. I like that it goes around the actual thruster. His pig's in here. There we go. And then finally... oh wait, it's a little loose. You gotta peg it in on an angle. A little bit of an angle. There we go. Just a little bit. And then the V-fin just goes... above the jewel, and you're done. That is the Earthree Gundam, fully complete, looking really great. I love this thing. I love the whole switching pieces. It's definitely taking the age line and like going all in. Definitely something they haven't done before, like to this extent. And I really do like it. It looks really good. No new stickers. Everything is colored plastic. Still just the cameras in the eyes, still. You can still see the jewel in the chest. Everything is pretty solid. Shoulder armor, once you get it pushed all the way in, it does seem to hold rather well. The backpack can be a little tricky. I have taken off and on a couple times because of other things you can do with it. So I think that's why it's not completely solid. The arms seem to be good. The skirts seem to be pretty good for now. Back skirt. The legs are good. Yeah. It's solid in this moon. I'm very happy with this. So the head is double ball jointed, but because of the thin collar, the bottom joint only goes forward and back. Still pretty good. The arms are ball jointed, although it is a little hard to get all the way around. You just have to move the hand out to get past that wing on the backpack. And it does have a hinge. You can kind of... it's got a little wiggle in it, really. So you can kind of use it a little bit, but not really. It kind of stops because this top... if you didn't have the top right on, you could probably utilize the actual polycap hinge. But it still goes up enough. Rotation below the elbow, or below the shoulder. Double-jointed elbow. You do have the ball-jointed wrist. You've got the ball-jointed waist, which once again is very close to the waist and it's hard to separate. It mostly swivels. You got the ball-jointed front skirt you can separate if you want. No side skirts. The legs can go forward. Go back, out pretty far, rotate at the thigh. You got a nice double jointed knee, which of course doesn't fit as well as it could because of the foot there. It just the way it has to be. I'm not gonna knock it. And then you have the ankle, which is very unique how they set this up, because the way it goes, these two halves clip into like a mushroom peg, so it rotates there, which is at an angle. And then you have the ball joint down here and the hinge, so you can bend it back and forth. And then with the ball joint, you can wiggle it, but also tilt. So if you rotate it, it's still at an angle, but because it's a ball joint, you can easily enough straighten it out. So they really did a good job with the feet, how they managed to make it all work and still be able to connect with the core foot. So yeah, the articulation is really good. They didn't have to sacrifice it for this whole combination transformation thing, and I'm really glad they figured it out. So, of course, it still has the beam saber handles, which are pegged very solidly onto the backpack, and it's still stressing the peg. Ugh, I guess even worse now. And you do have the thin beams, or the short beams, but also the normal size beams, which will just simply peg in there. And it can still be held. It's weird because it, I don't know if you notice, it holds it, I feel the weird way, like the width way, but that's how it goes in. I still feel like it's really like that, but then the blade's flat, so it's weird. I don't get it. It's kind of weird. It's not a big problem, it's just weird to me that it has the, it feels like it's holding it the wrong way. Probably just me. Then, of course, you can take the old little shield and take the new part, and it just goes through these holes. Really, like that. Now you got the new shield. And you can just rotate the hand, and you have a little tab there. Tabs into the arm, handle into the hand, like that. Got a little sensor there. You can take the beam rifle, and then, or the beam, I think it is called the beam spray gun, I was right before. You can take the beam rifle and the new piece, and they just go together, like that. I have the new beam rifle, which fits the same as it did with the core gun, because it's the exact same handle, no problem there. But then, you can do the whole connection thing like you did in the show. Now, you have to take these little bits and then put them into the little gap above it. So that it, like, open, looks like it's spread apart. Which is fine, but I can see this wearing out very fast. And then I love the fact that it's very easy to connect it to the shield. You just have to, because of the articulation on the arms. And there it is together. Very simple to do. Holds together very well. So, okay, I say that and then it moved. But it does hold together. There we go. Looks good. I like it. I'll probably keep the beam rifle, these end pieces, closer together. But yeah, it works good and it looks good. So, there is one more thing that I need to show. And that is the new connector. Now, this is the one they tell you to use for the core gun. You can still use it on this one, on the Earthree mode. But you have the this backpack. Oh, shoulder came off. So you just have to take off the flight pack and then attach this one, which still gives you the thruster. This is essentially for those, because the weapons for the next two suits versions, you have to have the buy the weapons separately, which I don't like, but you do. And these will basically give you ports to attach those if you want to use them on here and not get the other versions of the core gun. Which I'm going to get them, but it's cool that they give you the option. And then if you want, you can still use the little port here if you want to have the shield store in the backpack. Which I'm sure will work on here as well, but I kind of like how this looks because it covers around here. This just kind of looks like a slab. That looks a little more conform to the overall design. And these parts can come separate just because the tab, once you do get it connected to the backpack, it is pretty secure and sometimes they separate. So yeah, I'm very happy with the accessories. They're, the connections are pretty secure in making them into the upgraded Earthree mode. And the fact that the shield and the rifle connect also pretty nicely. So yeah, accessories are pretty good. So I'll use the same mobile suits that I used in the core Gundam comparisons. So we'll start with the... I guess we'll start with the Star Burning for a good comparison there, since it's also from the Build series. And also the for the last series, the Base Gundam. And I think I'll throw in the Gem Gem, because I just like the design of the Gem Gem. And then finally, the Age Normal, because once again, it feels like it's a progression of the whole limb swapping thing that the Age did. And that is the Earthree Gundam. Very cool. I like the name system just because it's like taking the planet and how far it is away from the sun and combining the words together. Yeah, the whole thing about this is really good. I'm very happy with it. There are still parts that seem to be stressing that I don't like. I'm kind of scared about the angles on the core Gundam. The tabs on the beam saber handles. Not really that big of a deal with the tabs on the, on this, the Earth, armor block. But other than that, things tab together well. They hold well enough. It looks great in both Core Gundam mode and Earthree mode. great articulation. First with the accessories. Yeah, very happy. So, if you want to pick the kit up, click the link below to go to Canadian Gundam, and I'll see you in the next review.